أعطيه مهمة، أعطيه مهمة كثيرة.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My name is Aqil Mohammed. I'm a high school student at John P. Stevens High School. I'm a regular reader of Masjid Bali and also an active member of my Muslim Student Association at my high school. With that being said, I'm here to talk to you how we can adopt Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's way of living into our daily lives. In this speech, I'm going to be talking about the humility of the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, how to humble ourselves to the point where no one knows our capabilities and our credentials. Because I don't have much time, I'll get straight to the point. In Islam, if you have even an atom's weight of pride, you're not going to enter Jannah. So how do we humble ourselves? Allah Ta'ala sent us the perfect example of a human being, the greatest creation of mankind, our beloved Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is indeed someone who all the Muslims look up to. And despite being the leader of the Muslim Ummah, he was and is the most humble person ever. Because I can't go more than 5 minutes, I'm going to focus on this one particular example. One of the closest companions of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu, said, I was riding behind the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam on a donkey. Now the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he passed away. He was a leader. There was no disputes about that. There was no competition from any other sources or any other tribe. He had at his disposal the wealth of the entire Arabian Peninsula. The wealth was in the hands of the Muslims. And Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam had full control of this. Despite this, because of his humbleness, his modesty, you see him riding on a donkey. He could have chosen a chariot with the most grand horses, eight or ten or dozens of horses, but just like emperors of Rome and princes of Persia would do. But no, because of his humbleness, he chooses a donkey, subhanAllah. And that's not the only thing. On top of that, he has Mu'adh sitting behind him on a donkey, sharing the donkey with Mu'adh. And what's so amazing about this is the fact that at this time, back then, kings had a strong sense of pride. I'm telling you, they had a strong sense of pride. They wouldn't share their horse, donkey, whatever with anyone. They felt like, this is literally what they would say. I'm the king, man. No way, I'm too good for you. This is basically what they would say. Rasulullah had no arrogance, richness, or ignorance. Nothing like pride, nothing like this existed in it. And you see Mu'adh holding on to him as the donkey's riding. SubhanAllah. Now, my dear brothers and sisters, let me mention one verse of the Quran from Surah Al-Furqan, chapter 45, ayah number 63. وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. The slaves of the most merciful are those who walk upon the earth humbly, and when the ignorant addresses them, they reply peacefully. Just look at this extremely beautiful ayah. And our Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam fits into this description. There's no one more humble than Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So my dear brothers and sisters, you don't have to go around telling everybody about your credentials all the time. Be yourself. Be humble. Hide your capabilities. Humble people don't put others down. And when others put humble people down, they deal with it in a peaceful manner. So, and as I said, basically here, I provided you an example of the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, how he was humble, and recited a verse from the Quran. Alright, I spoke about it, you guys listened to it, you guys might explain it to your friends. But the real question here is, did you act upon it? Did you act upon this knowledge, my dear brothers and sisters? Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is going to ask me, Aqeel, my noble servant, you spoke about humbleness in this speech. Did you act upon it? What am I going to answer? Allah Ta'ala is then going to ask you guys, whether I'm expecting a 16-year-old high school sophomore, offer you guys some valuable knowledge. Did you guys act upon it? Alright, my dear brothers and sisters, what I've noticed here is that the arrogance that we display is just a masking of some insecurity we feel. In other words, it can be completely eliminated. You get rid of it. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam never had any arrogant personality in him. So why can't we? If we love him that much, let's get rid of the arrogance that's in ourselves. Now, I don't want to take any more time because we're definitely brothers and sisters here who have speeches definitely better than mine. So let me end by saying this. May Allah Ta'ala guide us all, make us become closer to the deen, increase our love for the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Allah Ta'ala, may He guide the youth, may He guide the youth who are struggling with their faith to become closer to the straight path. May He guide the youth and allow them to see the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam as a role model. So thank you for your time. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasanah wa fil akhirati hasanah wa qina adhaban an-nar. Jazakallahu khairan. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.